Hey guys, so today we're going to be looking at side control, but with your opponent's arm on the high side of your head right here, okay? So, and these are all going to be variations off the Kimura. We'll do the Kimura first. So in this situation, I'm usually thinking, I'm trying to keep his arm trapped tight here. You can, you know, block him, put you in guard by blocking his leg here, or just keep your knee real tight. So you're controlling here, keep it real tight. A lot of times what he's going to want to do is try to escape this arm because he feels like his arm's trapped. And he's going to think, oh, this is something good. I'm getting my arm free. Like he's going to be able to do something, right? So as he gets his arm free, you're watching for it. Boom. Just grip the wrist. Grip your own wrist. You can either drive his wrist that direction as you lift the shoulder elbow slightly, or you can scissor your legs here. Scissor again. Kick over. And crank here. Okay, so that's the first technique. Now, let me give you three variations when the opponent defends against it. First one, this is one of my favorite techniques, but let me tell you, be really careful when you're doing this on your training partners, because they're going to feel like their arm's going to snap, their forearm's going to snap, and it may snap. So be real careful when you're doing this. So same situation, I got it trapped real tight. He's trying to escape it, comes down, I grip it, so I'm going for the Kimura here. But he's grappled before. He's grabbing his pants, right? He's trying to prevent you from going for that. So the first thing you're going to do here is you're going to take this hand is going to come out. I'm sorry, this hand comes down here. This hand grabs your elbow. This hand grabs your other elbow. His elbow's locked in here tight, so he can't move it out. He's trapped. So I'm going to go around his head, scissor this direction, get a nice wide base, and go crank it this way, okay? Most likely his hand is still trapped. He actually can't get it off of his pants or off of his waist, and it's just a ton of pressure, all right? And you may snap his forearm, so be real careful with that. So that's two. Number three, same situation. He thinks he's doing something good by escaping it. You trap it for Kimura, he grabs his pants, you turn it this direction. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to scissor here, get wide base. I'm going to kick over, control his wrist. Look at this, I'm going to control his wrist with this hand. Grab my foot, put it in this space here. Okay? Remember, he's still trying to protect against the Kimura. I'm free to do whatever I want at this point. So I can put a hand down, base up, come back, grip, lift him. He's still holding. So at this point, I'm going to just fall on my side, kick my leg over, and here, see the angle his arm's at? All I have to do is straighten my leg this direction, and it's a really strong shoulder lock. Most likely, he's going to get it up before that. Obviously, you have arm bar. So that's technique number three. Number four, same thing. He's protecting against Kimura. He brought it down. I trapped it. He got smart, he grabbed his pants, he's fighting like crazy. I'm going to scissor, control his wrist, grab my foot, put it in. Again, I come up, lift him up on his side. Again, my foot's going to go in front of his neck here. But this time, from right here, my shin is tight against his throat here. So I just reach behind his head, pull up while I drive my shin that direction. And you get a choke slash neck crush, okay? Pretty similar to the go-go plata choke. All right, so there's four things you can do from side control when you're going for the Kimura arm lock.